Okay, so the first thing is to have the target level open, so it finishes compiling all shaders. Then, check what Unreal version you are using to open these assets. We are on the latest version, which is currently 5.4.4. Now, close the editor. So, when you get the exporter, you'll have a main archive, which is this one. Extract it, like I did here. And inside, you'll have a few archives with pre-built binaries for a specific Unreal version. Assets for Unreal are usually built for a specific Unreal version, so it matters what version you use to open the assets, and then that's the version we will extract to a folder. We just used Unreal Engine version 5.4.4 for these assets, so we're going to extract this one. We're going to copy this to where we have our project. Our project is test.utg. We might kind of folder here called plugins. Paste the plugin. Rename this to just be Unreal To Godot. And then open the project. Now, inside the project, you'll now see this new button. Next up, we need to open a map. And then choose Unreal To Godot, Export To Godot. You have a few options here, just click OK. Then you can open Godot. Now, when you first open Godot, you have to wait for the asset import to finish. After you've waited, you can open the exported level, which is Hellcage Final, that I have already opened here. And this is it. You just exported an Unreal level to Godot, complete with materials, with visual shaders, textures, lights, and everything else. Now let's go back and talk about a few issues and options. In cases where you might not have a map, a mini tool to create a map with selected assets. Just create a new level. Click on the static mesh filter. Select all static meshes. And select the place all assets in scene. And as you can see, all of the static meshes are now in the scene. And it can be exported as usual with the export to Godot option. Also, if your scene has terrain, you need to first select convert landscape to static meshes. Now the export options. Shaders. You can export the Unreal materials as visual shaders or the standard material. Visual shaders are the recommended way because it will try to export the entire complexity of the Unreal material, including procedural texturing and animations. The standard material will just use the standard material in Godot, but know that each slot in Godot only accepts one texture. So if the Unreal material has more complex logic like multiple albedo textures with masks or detailed texturing, only a single texture will be assigned. Usually the first one in the node chain. Skin meshes. You have the option to export as a skin mesh or convert it to a static mesh before export. Nanite options. Since nanite meshes have millions of triangles, they will run very poorly in Godot. You have the option to export the coarse mesh, which is a simplification of the original mesh, but this mesh can also contain errors, especially for foliage meshes. Or export the original mesh, which can contain millions of triangles. Export brushes. Unreal scenes sometimes contain a brush component actor. These for some reason randomly crash when converted to static meshes, which is why it's off by default. But if you find missing geometry in your level, it could be due to brushes. So try a second export with the brushes on. And the export textures. You'll probably want to export textures most of the time, but in cases where you don't, you can untick this. It's also possible in Godot that you might encounter a few other problems. I have an updated list on the product page and a FAQ document that I keep updated with solutions, so check those first. In cases where you have a new issue, then just contact me by email and I'll try to solve it. Thanks.